Hello friends, this is Durga from IT Varsity. As part of this video, I will try to cover how you can be socially active to get traction to your profile, and it will be added to the playlist IT Job Marketing. And these are the topics that will be covered. So socially active, endorsements and recommendations in LinkedIn, blogs, YouTube, open source, committing in open source communities and meetup. These are the things which will be covered to make yourself socially active. So first thing is endorsements and recommendations. As everyone who is into services industry, primarily into IT, they should have LinkedIn account at the least. And as part of that, as I have explained in the earlier videos, it has endorsements and recommendations section. So to add the endorsements, you can click on edit profile and scroll down, and the first thing you need to do is add the skills. So the skills you add should be in line with your job interests, and it has limitation of 50 skills, so you cannot go beyond 50. So people might add or endorse any skill, and if you are not interested in that skill, you can discard it in the beginning itself. At any point in time, when you click on edit profile and go to the skills and endorsements, you can click on this icon to add the skill to the list, and then people will start endorsing it. And also there is a manage button also. By clicking on this edit button, it will take to manage any of the thing. You can click and it will take you to edit option, and if you don't want to be endorsed on your skills, you can choose no, but if you want endorsements to your skills, you can choose yes. So include me in endorsement suggestions to make connections. So if you want to be endorsed by connections, so for example, if I log in as Big Data Mentor, which is another LinkedIn profile, let me log out from this one. Sign in. I'm using another profile, bigdatamentor@gmail.com. The one which I have in Firefox is dgajraju@gmail.com. That is mapped to that LinkedIn account, and this one is bigdata.mentor@gmail.com. And here I can go to my account, Durga Gajraju, and here it will ask you to endorse on skills whenever you view others' profiles. Okay, and that one, if you want to be included in endorsement suggestions to your connections, then you have to choose this first option. And show me suggestions to endorse my connections. So whenever I log in, if I want to get suggestions for people in my network, then you have to enable this. And this one is to send notifications so that you can view here to see the endorsements you got. Okay. And then you can add or remove a skill over here. And you can delete it directly from here also. And also you can type expertise here and click on add. So to delete, you have to click on this X icon in each of these skills. To add, you just have to type it here and click on add. And then there is another tab called manage endorsements. So here you can move your endorsements. You can reorder your endorsements by just... No, I think they have changed the functionality a little bit. If you want to move, you can go to add or remove endorsements and you can move it around like this. Okay. Earlier it used to be part of manage endorsements, but I think you can still move your okay, this is to go below, go to the rest of your endorsements. So you cannot actually move using manage endorsements tab, but what you can do is, once you choose the endorsement, if you don't want to see endorsement from particular people, you can deselect that thing. and only the things which you want to show can show up. I don't know why they have added, but you can have that level of control on your endorsements. Endorsements is very important, especially to get traction for your profile. And also, as LinkedIn is integrated with other applications, you can have a matching. So if you think from the job recruiter perspective, if I can tap into this endorsements of the profiles based upon my job description which I publish, it can go to the LinkedIn profiles and do the matching based upon the endorsements, and it can recommend that the relevant most relevant candidates for your job description. So having endorsements matching to the job descriptions can be a significant boost if someone uses applications which are integrated with LinkedIn to recruit in their organizations. So it has huge potential, and I will highly recommend to go with endorsements. And also, when you get endorsements, make sure you receive endorsements from the relevant people. If a recruiter endorses you on a Hadoop, then it need not be relevant to your profile, or it can put your profile in bad light. These days, there are a lot of fake profiles which are endorsed by fake accounts, and it is very easy to catch. So make sure you got endorsed from your colleagues, supervisors, and subordinates in the areas you are interested in, rather than reaching out to recruiters or your trainer in technology. That will not take your profile. It is easy to catch those things if LinkedIn wants to in future. So be very careful about whom who are endorsing you and whom you are endorsing. Unless you have working relationship, don't try to endorse others unless there is other reasons. For example, I am teaching Hadoop in detail, so you know that I am good in Hadoop, so you can endorse me in Hadoop. There is no harm in that. But as a student of Hadoop, you cannot reach out to me to ask endorse you unless I have working relationship with you, or we have some discussions where I actually quantify your capabilities in Hadoop. I will not be able to endorse you. It is not fair. So you have to be extremely careful whom you are asking for the endorsements to build your profile over time. And another important aspect of leveraging your social networking platform and get traction to your profile is the recommendations. Recommendations should only seek from your supervisors, peers, and subordinates, not from anyone you want. That is not good, and people can get hold of it very easily. So in this case, I have endorsement from different people, from different organizations. So these guys are primarily my clients and my peers, as well as my supervisors. So you have to be extremely careful with whom you, from whom you have got the recommendation. And once you have the recommendations, you can click on the manage button, and you can, if you don't want to display a certain recommendation, you can hide it. And if you want to show only certain recommendations, you can display those things. So I have many recommendations, but I don't display everything on my profile. Okay, for example, this one I just hide it because it does not match my interests into which I want to go. So I have 11 recommendations, only 2 of them are visible and 9 hidden for this position at YU. And for the position with IBM, I have 2 recommendations and both of them are visible. So it's very easy to manage the recommendations. So that is about endorsements and recommendations. Very easy to get traction, but that is not enough. As I mentioned to you, there is a lot of fake accounts and fake endorsements in the market. So unless you are socially active through other platforms as well, your profile will not get enough traction. One of that is blog, and your blog should be as niche as possible. You cannot just write a blog on some irrelevant stuff or the stuff which everyone is aware of. For example, if you are expert in Oracle and if you have done some advanced performance tuning techniques, you can write an article on that. And what will happen is when you post it, and if you have Oracle-based managers, administrators, architects in your network, they will get the they will get to see that article, and if they are going through the similar problems, you can get actual opportunities through them. So writing a blog in niche areas and publishing through your network, who are relevant audience for your article, will give you a lot of traction for your profile. And it should be as niche as possible. You cannot just write a primitive article on Oracle Performance Tuning about how to read explain plan and all those things. You have to understand those unique problems which you have solved and which are tough to get by just Googling around. Those things you can post it as an article, and it will give you a lot of traction for your profile. And then the next one is YouTube, another very strong social networking platform where you can actually upload content as videos. So you cannot fake that easily when you actually start publishing content on YouTube. So you can have a channel in YouTube and you can start uploading content in the areas which you are strong, and you can publish those things in your network. You can demonstrate about your niche ideas. You can consolidate content from different channels and create a new content by writing an article. So there are many ways you can leverage on top of YouTube. So to understand how to publish content on YouTube, I already have a playlist publishing content to ITversity, taking my channel as a content publisher. I have uploaded a playlist which is around 9 videos, and it will cover all those aspects of how to effectively publish content to YouTube and also market on social networking platforms. So you can go through this, and definitely it will give you a lot of traction compared to just having the LinkedIn profile without much activity. Okay, and coming to blogs, there is another thing. So you can actually do a PPT also, as I have explained earlier, and use the SlideShare platform of LinkedIn, and you can publish your PPTs in SlideShare, and you can actually share that one PPT on multiple social networking platforms from SlideShare. It will also help you a lot in getting traction to your profile. And then you can be an open source committer. So GitHub is the most popular open source platform where you can commit your code. So you can have a GitHub account, and you can start uploading your code repository, which can be leveraged by different people. Okay, and not only that, most of the open source technologies, they commit through GitHub. Once you have GitHub profile, you can volunteer yourself to be a committer to those GitHub repositories of open source platforms like Hadoop, edX, and many others. And you can start publishing the or providing the code in the repository or commit to the existing repositories. And the advantage of using GitHub is you can upload the code, and if you are an open source committer, for example Hadoop, before accepting your commit, those Hadoop core team or Hadoop architects or developers who are there in that repository for a long time will review your code. They will provide the comments, and all those things are kept track in GitHub. So you need to have some deeper understanding about GitHub. If you are a passionate developer, then I will highly recommend to have a GitHub account and start committing to the open source community, and it will give you a lot of credibility to your profile over time. And there are occasions where people are hired just by looking at GitHub profile without having any interviews. Okay, and it is very tough to fake platforms like GitHub, unlike in LinkedIn. So having a GitHub account for a passionate developer will definitely take it to next level once you start committing, or once you start uploading your code base for others. And then Meetups. Meetups is another very cool platform where you can collaborate with others in person and try to build your network to get traction for your profile. Meetup.com is another website. And it is primarily to meet people in person in your location. There are occasions where people meet online also, but primarily meetups are meant for meeting in person. You can have an account by clicking on sign up, and you can authenticate directly with Facebook also, Facebook or Google Plus. So I already have an account authenticated through Facebook, so I logged in. So you can, if you are interested in Hadoop, you can just search for Hadoop meetups. It will by default search only within 2 miles in Bangalore, and you can click on search button, and it will give all the meetups. Why it is giving everything? Okay, let me search for groups. Yeah, so using Hadoop, when I search for groups, so these are the groups in Bangalore. There is one for Apache Hadoop ecosystem, which have 90 people in the meetup. Like that, there are many others. So you can sign up for them, and they will publish whenever they are going to conduct a meetup. And you can go to the meetup in person. You can meet with other people. That way you can actually meet like-minded people at your level and at your supervisor level and even at your subordinate level. And you can exchange the ideas. You can build the network. It will give you a lot of traction to your profile. I have seen occasions where people are hired just based upon meetups, especially when it comes to startups, because you can exhibit your passion in person, and if people are looking if the employers are looking for people like you, it is very easy to get traction in meetup if you are part of a relevant meetup and get hired. So have a meetup account and try registering or subscribing to the meetups in your interest areas, in your location, and try to go to meetups in person and keep in touch with people to get traction to your profile. So these are the platforms which you can leverage: endorsements and recommendations of LinkedIn, blogs, and sharing it on SlideShare, YouTube account. Be an open source committer and be part of regular meetups regularly, and it will definitely take your profile or your career to next level. It will definitely help you. That being said, that's it. I will try to upload more videos as and when new platforms comes in this context. So this playlist will be an open-ended playlist. So keep following it, and you will get all the relevant content for IT job marketing. And as part of the next video, we will be seeing how to leverage Dice and Monster job portals to effectively search for the jobs and reduce the time to get the job matching your interests and requirements. Okay. So that being said, I hope you are enjoying the content on my channel. If you like this video, please click on the like button. If you want to provide feedback or ask any questions, please use the comment section of the video. And if you are not subscribed to my channel yet, please do so. You will get to see a lot more content like this over time. Thank you. Bye.